It smells like home. I walk in and that smell fills my nostrils to the brim. That smell. That warm, gooey smell of Dominican cake sold by the slice and dulce de coco squares over dulce de leche squares on cake pedestal stands with aguacates underneath. And the single-serving chiclet boxes coming in flavors like yerba buena, also known as spearmint, mixing in with the clear plastic-wrapped caramelo cubes that decorate the counter. And the bread case, full of panes de aguas to your right while the guayaba squares are to your left, and there's the radio with the bachata playing and the smell. That smell. Of plátanos and frutas tropicales and wooden crates and the narrow aisles full of mistolín on one side and the velas, all the prayer candles, Santa Barbara, Michango would be proud. And there's that smell of Old Spice worn by a man like my grandfather sporting guayaberas mixing in with the smell of country fruit sodas. They look like rainbow Skittles, yellow for merengue, red for fresa, orange for naranja, and purple for uva. Next to the four screen presidentes, all cold and frothy front and center when you open the cooler door. Y ese olor a cerveza y a comida that someone brought him during his lunch hour from the Dominican joint around the corner. That smell of aluminum tins full of maduros and arroya habichuela, and that smell that reminds me of the sound of calixos, Dominican flip-flops slapping on sideways and inclined runways, and the kind abuela always had as we, my cousins and I, chased and poked each other with the needles from the lime tree out front. It's that smell. That smell of loud-ass kids with that in-between hair because they're about the high yellow red-born ones. That smell of pressed hair as the ladies come in freshly coiffed from El Salón. There is nothing like having your hair blown out by a Dominican. You know someone, trust me. These women coming in looking to cool down with the cold one because you know they don't want to sweat it out. And that smell of Santo Domingo carrying carteras de pan y zapaticos de charol and cousins and aunts and uncles. And that smell that smells nothing like what's outside the doorway. This bodeguita doesn't smell like the liquor that is poured on the sidewalk for those that aren't here anymore. It doesn't smell like the fume from the markers that have been used to tag the wall next to the pictures placed above. Rest in peace, insert non-government name here. For those who have been baptized by the street, rituals and burials don't involve caskets. Street cred is solidified through makeshift altars that celebrate a life ended too soon, while tags commemorate how the badge of honor was earned. And there's that smell. That smell. Seeping out the door of the bodeguita to say, this wouldn't have happened there. At least not in this way. That smell mixing in with the cigarettes of the women hanging out their windows shadowed by curtains that always bear fruit. That smell of agua florinda and Johnson & Johnson baby powder, of La Luana, of Bayshore, of Brentwood, of Washington Heights, of Warren's Mass, of pesos dominicanos taped behind store counters next to the cash registers. And that damn smell that washes over me and wraps me up in a hug and I am warmed by nostalgia, reminding me that this bodeguita tucked away from my, around the corner that I rarely go into reminds me of something not very common but all too familiar. And I realize that this place, this space, smells like home.